Hello everyone, and welcome back to my efficient design series in Kerbal Space Program 0.24.2. In this episode, we're basically going to be bouncing this probe around all over the place. After it finishes up with Minmus, we're sending it over to the Moon, then over to Ike, then over to Joule, and that is to fulfill some contracts which require us to transmit data from around Ike, and then do the same after achieving orbit around Joule. Now, basically it's just a floating fuel tank with an engine at the back, and it happens to have some science on it, at least that's what it looks like, but recall that the cost of this is mostly the gravioli detector, and so, yeah, it's a pretty serious gravioli probe, and it is capable of possibly returning back to Kerbin and bring back the last reading on the gravioli detector, so that's why it's got a parachute at the top. So, and of course, that's because we wanted it to be reusable, because that's what we're doing in this series. So, we are here to... We won't really finish up with Minmus. It seems like it's going to be difficult to actually finish up all of the science we could possibly do, because the gravioli detector is, biome dependent as far as the planets that actually have biomes. Now, I've decided that I want to get a little bit closer to Minmus on reflection, and that'll make my encounter with the Moon a little bit harder, but I want to make sure that I get low over Minmus a few readings there. We can readjust later. It's only 4 meters per second from out here, so it's a good idea to do it. Okay. So, this is a science-gathering mission, and also fulfilling contracts, of course. So, we've got almost 300 science right now, but we're trying to... this is really our first major foray with the gravioli detector, so basically we haven't done any gravioli stuff at all. And since it's biome-dependent, maybe things have turned around enough so that I can log gravity data again? Yeah. Electric charge is the issue. That was the major flaw in the way I designed this, now I remember. let's make sure we're all pointed properly. Seems like just having one panel face the sun is the best policy. They're angled a little bit too much to be worthwhile in any other direction. We're still on slopes. But we can transmit this 13. We missed that last time. I checked our contracts, and the one that might come up during all this is planting a flag on the Moon. So, might have to do that sometime in the middle of this excursion with this little adventure with this probe. Come on, Minmus should be turning all over the place, yes. Lowlands we've already done. I guess I'll transmit the 3.8. Wow, even for 3.8 it takes all of my electric charge? Come on. So apparently we're going to get biomes in all of the other planets in 0.26, which should be interesting. Time warp going there. Still high over. They're gonna have to rebalance the whole tech tree because of that, because there'll be a lot more science to gain. Probably rebalance the contracts as well. That feels like we just transitioned into low. Let's see. Yes, just above. Okay. Looks like what we really needed was about 300 electric charge per transmission. Well, we're only gonna get part of this, but we better go for it. Well, these are the perils with quick encounters. So now let's adjust our trajectory so that we can meet up with the Moon. You can see the gap there. probably I want to make the moon pull my orbit in, so we're going to have to sort of approach it properly for that. Let's see. No, that's getting too wild. It's probably better to try that out once we get closer. Yeah, we'll fine-tune the moon approach as we get closer. Ah, that's the minimum anyway. Okay, so out we go, leaving Minmus, our first scientific location. Probably there's another biome here, isn't there? Highlands, yeah. Well, I guess it's sort of good that we're not getting all of the science from each of these, because that means that if we get a future contract to do more science in orbit around Minmus, we can finish it up. So there's a plus side to ending up not having enough electric charge. Okay, so now we see the resulting orbit from our encounter with the moon, and I don't think that's a good idea right there. That looks like it could be a recipe for disaster, so I guess that'll have to do for starters. Time to check where Duna is. Okay, we're gonna be hanging out around here for a while. And Jules over there. We might end up having a Jewel encounter first. Possible. Maybe we'll be going to Jewel first. We'll see. That'll be a little bit more dangerous, though, in terms of our Delta V. Looks like we're just going to be skirting the moon. Oh, well. No real close encounter without damaging our future trajectory. Here it is. Moon's Highlands. Okay, I will take that. Now, what's our periapsis? That's okay. We just have to make sure that we're not flung out by the moon or... Well, I guess it's not okay. We should try to get aerobraked by Kerbin, but not on this pass. Okay, let's see if we can send another batch. Moon's poles. Well, that's rare. So, note to self, no matter how much science it is, the gravity only takes 300 electric charge to send it. That's sort of important information to know. Got a little bit more there. Huh, that was an interesting effect. I think I briefly tricked the thing into recharging. I don't know. Up a little bit more from the Midlands, okay. Now let me try that. Yes! I can trick the game into thinking I have more electric charge than I do. There we go, electric charge didn't run out there, did it? Okay, well, I guess I will exploit that flaw. Let's go around. We need to get a closer orbit with Kerbin, but we need to do the burn from out here to keep it efficient. We just need a conservative little barely aerobraking kind of thing. That'll do. And that's because I don't know if my the orbit to get out to Ike or Joule will be going in this direction, so we really need to pull this back in, but I don't want to use too much delta V to do that. Maybe I don't need to pull it back in. Yeah, maybe we should just escape. We're just so close to escape anyway. Oh, we've done a few passes, and now we've got a moon encounter that lowers our orbit, so I'm just going to take it. I'm not going to try and adjust at all. Now, this moon pass doesn't really get us any closer to the moon, but we'll see if we can do some more science. So, for those keeping track, one Minmus pass. This is the second moon pass with this mission. A little bit more from the highlands. Okay, I'm done with trying to get any more from this pass. Actually, taking a look at the tracking station, we're pretty close to Joule transfer point here. And what would happen, let's say, if I try to... Let's switch back to the mission. So, as I was saying, what would happen if I tried to burn out a periapsis here? Pretty close. Our orbit is not bad. Yeah. Well, this is excellent. This is possibly the best situation possible where our apoapsis happens to be in the right direction this time. So we're actually able to burn out a periapsis, and all of this is to our benefit, actually. It's a good thing I didn't try to drop my orbit after all. It's of course giving me two versions of the resulting orbit just to annoy me. Oh, that's the one I want. There we go. We have to get into orbit around Joule, by the way, so it's not a possibility for us to have Joule slingshot us back to Duna slash Ike. Well, it doesn't get any better than this. I mean, this is pretty much what transfer to Duna would have cost without already having the orbit all the way out to Minmus. Or, actually, we brought it in, so all the way out to the moon. Actually, it was past the moon already. I think it was all the way out to Minmus or close to it. Okay, 331 kilometers, 135 meters per second. With that, on the 71st day of this mission, or is it 72nd? It's actually the 72nd day. We started day zero, right? So, yeah. We are out to Jupiter, Joule, that thing. Okay, just past the mid-course plane change node, and here we go. Well, you hit a minimum there. Okay, where is it pointing at right now? Ooh, what's that? Lathe encounter. I don't mind if I do. Yeah, actually. That could be interesting. Okay, oh, a tile encounter. And a lathe encounter. Okay, let's just do that. This could be bad though, but let's find out. Let us find out. This seems like a fortuitous event and I can't resist. Oh, do we get to do gravioli in outer space? Where are you, gravioli? It's the downside of tucking them behind these things. Okay. Yeah, in space high over the sun. Okay. Worth quite a lot, actually. So let's do the time warping trick. Yep, got all the science. Some sort of interesting rounding error there. Uh-oh. Looks like we can't access our bank accounts from all the way out here. Or our reputation. Still got a read on our science, though. Strange. Okay, so Tyloperiapsis coming in. We're coming in the right direction, but we're coming in high over Jewel. But we might be encountering Lathe on the way in. I'll risk it. Let's see. I want that Tylo encounter. Let's see how good we can get our Tylo encounter so that brings us closer to Jewel or to Lathe. If it'll let me create a maneuver node. No, it's overlapping the numbers. That's not good. Lathe encounter on the way out. That's not helpful. Actually, maybe we can get Lathe to airbrake us. But I'd rather get Jewel to do that. Maybe. I can't even see the numbers right now. I don't know if there's an angle that... No, I mean, changing the angle does not let me see any new numbers. I'm gonna do this this burn to get the Lathe encounter on the other side, and then after we pass Tylo, I'll decide what to do. It's not a great idea, because it's gonna cost more to... I guess I should just be resolute and pick one. It's either going to be we're airbraking at Lathe or we're airbraking at Jewel. I think it's safer to airbrake at Jewel. Just because we're on the way out like that. Wish I could see the Jewel periapsis though. Sort of a helpful number. Let's see, zooming in. Okay. We lose our Tylo encounter there. I at least want to encounter it a little bit. Okay, so we'll do that, and then we'll have to do another burn to get even closer to Jewel. Or maybe we can use Tylo to help, but let's figure this out first. If it wasn't a contract requirement to get an orbit around Jewel, I'd just hit Tylo, Jewel, then Lathe, and then that'll be that, but no such luck. That should be it, I think. Okay, let's go. This costs a lot. No. Costs a lot too. Maybe this was a bad decision. Let's see if I can get Laith back. Yeah, I'm just gonna go for Laith encounter and see whether we can get Laith to airbreak us. Because I can't get close to Jewel right now. It's costing too much. Uh-oh. Oh, we have an electric charge boo-boo. Okay. I can't send any signals. Foiled. Yep. Yep. Zero. Well, this is our Tylo encounter. But it's completely useless. I can't do any of the experiments. Probably we'll be facing the other direction once we come around Jewel, but by then it might be too late. I mean, definitely too late for Tylo. It might be even too late for the mission here. Still no electric charge. And we're not even encountering Leaf now. Past Jewel. It isn't reorienting us at all. Well, I think I'm going to have to call this a complete failure. We did not encounter Jewel. We did not, well, we didn't really get signs from Jewel. We didn't get signs from Ike. All because electric charge. So, this probe was definitely fundamentally flawed, and there's no way to bring it back in. You might think, okay, well, maybe we can encounter something else later on and try and recover the situation. We've got fuel. We've got plenty of Delta V left. But not only do we not have the electric charge to save the situation, but take a look at the orbit that Jewel has pushed us out into. It's 68 years to apoapsis. And so this guy is now more like a comet than anything else. So yeah, in the next episode I am going to attempt something completely different and try and let's go back to the Space Center to see what our actual numbers are. And for those viewers who aren't clear about it, I don't revert, I don't redo anything in these episodes. If I fail, that's it. So, didn't pay attention to electric charge, gets recorded, gets uploaded to YouTube. So, there we are. Doesn't happen too often, but it happened this time. 2.3 million. Quite a good reputation despite a recent failure. I guess they don't know about that. They really don't. And 537.4 science. We still got the contracts to do. We still need to plant a flag on Ike in 5 years. A flag on the moon in 2 years, and the science data that we were trying to get, as well as an Eve mission. The most interesting thing is probably the Eve mission. That's very lucrative too. Not that we need the money, mind you. And then the Jewel mission, of course. We really need to take our revenge on Jewel. Let's take a look at the tech tree. With all the probe stuff, I think we need to aim for planes, and I'm really hankering for the Rapier engine here. We're a little bit short of the science we need for that, but only a little bit. So maybe we can pick up some trivial science at the start of the next episode and then unlock that as a priority. And of course, this is the last time we get to use the original parts for building a space plane, because 0.25, they've got new parts. So I do want to take advantage of that as much as possible. The RTG is looking great at this point, of course. So we've got two competing really good things that we could unlock, the Rapier engine and the RTG. So I'll think that over. Anyway, so I'll try something completely different in the next episode, because this was a bummer. So thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please do press like. If you have any comments or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. And I'll see you next time.